Hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PID 24/7. I am Manish Mishra and guys, in today's session we are going to discuss about the mission Karma Yogi, that is very important mission that was launched by the government of India recently, and also we are going to discuss about the latest NCRB data on suicides and accidental deaths. Well, suicides or accidental deaths ke upar NCRB ne data release kiya hai, so we are going to discuss it in detail. And also, since today is Friday, so at the end of the session, I'll bring to you 5 questions in the form of quiz. So, chaliye start karte hain with question number 1, which is about the NCRB data related to suicides and the accidental death. So, the annual NCRB data contains detailed statistical information on the accidental deaths, injury and suicides in the country has been released. Which of the following is correct about the information given in the report? Inme se kya us report ke baare mein sahi hai, right? So let us discuss the news first. So recently NCRB has released this data on accidental deaths, injury and suicides, and according to this data, jo number of suicide cases and accidental deaths hai, the number of suicide cases and accidental deaths registered in the year 2019 has been increased from the figures that were recorded in the year 2018. 2019 mein jo data hai of the suicide and accidental deaths, वो increase हो गया है as compared to the previous recorded data that was in the year 2018. And according to this data, जो accidents है, that has been increased by 2.3% and suicides is increased by 3.4%. And also according to this report, in 2019, हर 4 मिनट में, in every 4 minutes, there is a case of suicide in our country. Alright. So this is a very major cause of concern for all of us, because इतनी ज्यादा सुसाइड्स बढ़ती जा रही है, हर 4 मिनट में हमारे देश में एक सुसाइड हो रहा है. एंड मेनली गाइस, सुसाइड का जो कारण होता है हमारे देश में, द मेन रीजन फॉर द सुसाइड्स इज द इंक्रीजिंग स्ट्रेस, इज द इंक्रीजिंग यू नो अर्बनाइजेशन की वजह से भी काफी स्ट्रेस बढ़ता जा रहा है. सो देयर आर वेरियस रीजंस अबाउट दिस सुसाइडल केसेस, राइट? सो इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द नंबर ऑफ डेथ्स इन लाख, so in 2018 due to suicide 1.3 lakh people died, in 2019 1.4 people died due to accidental deaths, due to accidents there were 4.1 lakh deaths in the year 2018, while in 2019 it was 4.2. agar aapko ye data yaad ho jata hai, then that is very good, otherwise there is no issue. You just have to remember this increase in percentage as compared to the year 2018. All right and if you talk about the suicide cases in detail, so the number of total number of suicides in the country has been increased to 1,39,123 in the year 2019 from the previous 1,34,516. You don't have to remember this data. In 2019, a person died by suicide every 4 minutes. Har 4 minutes mein ek person suicide karta hai in India in the year 2019. And one in every 3 of the 1,40,000 people who died of suicide in 2019 took this step due to the family problems. Jo hamare badhte hue फैमिली प्रॉब्लम्स है आजकल लोगों को, न्यूक्लियर फैमिली, एवरीवन इज प्रेफरिंग द न्यूक्लियर फैमिली. सो दिस न्यूक्लियर फैमिली इज द मेजर कॉज ऑफ कंसर्न, इज द मेजर रीजन फॉर दिस इंक्रीजिंग नंबर ऑफ सुसाइड्स इन आवर कंट्री. ओके, एंड 10,281 फार्मर्स, कल्टिवेटर्स एंड फार्म लेबरर्स वर देयर हु कमिटेड सुसाइड इन द ईयर 2019, विच इज डाउन फ्रॉम 10,357 इन द ईयर 2018. एंड इन टोटल देयर वर 7.4% ऑफ द फार्मर्स आउट ऑफ द टोटल पीपल who committed suicide in the year 2019. And guys, aapko itna sara data, you don't have to remember all this data. You just have to remember this, that the farmers comprise 7.4% of all the people who died due to suicide. You should remember this, that in 2019, a person died by suicide every 4 minutes. So these two facts are very important. And if you talk about the accidental cases, so accidental cases mein sabse zyada jo cases hain, that is due to traffic accidents, which amounts to 43% of all the such accidental cases. दिल्ली में सबसे ज्यादा डेथ्स हुई हैं बिकॉज ऑफ एक्सीडेंट्स ड्यू टू डेंजरस ड्राइविंग एंड ओवरऑल रोड एक्सीडेंट्स इन द ईयर 2019. एंड जो सडन डेथ्स ड्रोनिंग और पॉइजनिंग के वजह से डेथ हुई हैं, वो अदर कॉजेज हैं ऑफ द एक्सीडेंटल डेथ्स इन आवर कंट्री, बट जो मेजर कॉज है दैट इज ट्रैफिक एक्सीडेंट, एंड इन दैट दिल्ली इज द नंबर 1. ऑलराइट, सो दिस वॉज अबाउट दिस न्यूज. एंड गाइज, इफ यू टॉक अबाउट एनसीआरबी, सो इट वॉज एस्टैब्लिश्ड इन द ईयर 1986 एंड it has the responsibility of collecting the crime data, right? It has the responsibility of collecting the crime data, and it works under the Ministry of Home Affairs. Remember this, it works under Ministry of Home Affairs, which is headed by Mr. Amit Shah, and it is headquartered in New Delhi. Ye kahan pe located hai? New Delhi mein. And the current director The current director of this organization, yes, is Mr. Ramphal Pawar. Yes, he is Mr. Ramphal Pawar. And now let's move on to the question, which of the following is correct? So between 2018 and 19, the number of people dying in accidents increased by 2.3. Yes. Between 2018-19, number of people dying due to suicides increased by 3.4. Yes. Farmers comprise 7.4%. Yes. In 2019, the person died by suicide every 4 minutes. So all of the above are the correct answer, option E. And now let's move on to the question number 2, which is again a very important question. Yahan se pucha ja sakta hai exam mein, bas isme se ek hi question pucha ja sakta hai, wo main aapko is question ke baad bataunga. Ministry of Youth Affairs and Sports added 20 new disciplines under sport quota. Athletes from 20 new disciplines, including indigenous and traditional sports like Mallakhamb, tug of war, roll ball, are also now eligible for the government jobs under the sports quota. So the question here is that what is the minimum eligibility criteria for the recruitment through the sports quota, and as per that minimum eligible criteria, we have to find the correct statement. Okay. And आपसे एग्जाम में फेज वन में ये क्वेश्चन पूछा जा सकता है दैट हाउ मेनी न्यू डिसिप्लिन्स आर एडेड अंडर द स्पोर्ट्स कोटा. एंड गाइस अर्लियर देयर वर 43 स्पोर्ट्स अंडर द स्पोर्ट्स कोटा एंड नाउ इट हैज बीन इंक्रीज्ड टू 63. ओके, सो वी हैव दिस न्यूज, एथलीट्स फ्रॉम 20 न्यू डिसिप्लिन्स विल नाउ बी एलिजिबल टू गेट द गवर्नमेंट जॉब्स अंडर द स्पोर्ट्स कोटा एंड दिस हैज बीन डन टू एंश्योर द ओवरऑल वेलफेयर ऑफ एथलीट्स. ओके, एंड द लिस्ट इज रिवाइज्ड फ्रॉम 43 स्पोर्ट्स टू 63 स्पोर्ट्स एंड इट वॉज last time revised in their 2013 in the month of October. And what will it do? So it will boost the morale of the sports person who are performing at national and international events, and it will also help in creating a positive environment for the overall development of the sports in the country. It is obvious guys ki agar hame ek hame opportunity milegi ki if we perform well in sports then we'll get a then we can get a government job in that particular sports, then we will definitely be हमें काफी ज्यादा अवेयरनेस होगी, हम काफी ज्यादा मोटिवेट होंगे, विल डेफिनेटली बी मोटिवेटेड टू प्ले दैट स्पोर्ट्स. ओके, सो ओके, सो नाउ व्हाट इज द क्वेश्चन, विच वन इज द करेक्ट अबाउट द मिनिमम एलिजिबिलिटी क्राइटेरिया. ओके, सो द स्पोर्ट्स पर्सन हु हैव परफॉर्म वेल इन नेशनल एंड इंटरनेशनल इवेंट्स आर एलिजिबल ओनली. नो गाइज, यू कैन ऑल्सो परफॉर्म वेल एट द स्टेट लेवल, सो देन ऑल्सो यू विल बी एबल टू गेट द गवर्नमेंट जॉब. Eligibility criteria depends on the pay scale of the job. Yes, pay scale पे भी depend करता है कि अगर मान लो कि ज्यादा pay scale की job है then उसमें ये देखा जाता है कि that you should play the national and international events. Okay, मतलब आपने किसी national या international events में part लिया है या नहीं लिया है. Okay, and the candidates are selected on the basis of written test or sports trial or the medical test followed by the interview. So statement number 2 and 3 are absolutely correct. So therefore option C will be the correct answer. And remember this that जो स्पोर्ट्स पर्सन का जो एलिजिबिलिटी है वो केवल नेशनल और इंटरनेशनल के लिए नहीं है, यू कैन ऑल्सो परफॉर्म वेल इन द स्टेट लेवल टू गेट अ गवर्नमेंट जॉब अंडर द स्पोर्ट्स कोटा. ऑलराइट, एंड नाउ लेट्स मूव ऑन टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 3 विच इज अबाउट द वाटर हीरोज कॉन्टेस्ट दैट वॉज लॉन्च बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ जल शक्ति विच इज हेडेड बाय मिस्टर गजेंद्र सिंह शेखावत एंड राउट डाउन इन कमेंट्स हिज लोकसभा कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी. ओके, सो दिस कॉन्टेस्ट वॉज लॉन्च फ्रॉम 1st ऑफ सेप्टेम्बर 2020. सो वॉट इज द पर्पज, इसका पर्पस क्या है? ओके, सो तो लेट मी टेल यू द आंसर फर्स्ट. इट्स पर्पस इज टू मेक वाटर कंजर्वेशन अ पीपल्स मूवमेंट. लोगों का मूवमेंट बनाने के लिए वाटर कंजर्वेशन को इसको लॉन्च किया गया है एंड दिस हैज बीन डन टू मेक वाटर कंजर्वेशन अ पीपल्स मूवमेंट एंड स्ट्रेंथन द वाटर कॉन्शियसनेस इन द कंट्री बिकॉज हमारे देश में पानी की जो है किल्लत बहुत ज्यादा है. देयर इज अ स्कार्सिटी ऑफ वाटर रिसोर्सेज ऑल ओवर द कंट्री. इनफैक्ट 21 सिटीज ऐसे हैं हमारे देश में जो कि एक दो साल के अंदर जिनके अंदर जो लैंड वाटर है, जो ग्राउंड वाटर है, बिल्कुल खत्म हो जाएगा. देर आर 21 सिटीज इन आर कंट्री वेयर इन अराउंड 2 to 3 years और इनफैक्ट 1 to 2 years देर विल बी नो ग्राउंड वाटर. ओके, सो इट इज अ मेजर कॉज ऑफ कंसर्न फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस बिकॉज वाटर इज अ बेसिक नेसेसिटी फॉर आवर लाइफ. सो वी शुड यूज वाटर इन अ जुडिशियल मैनर. ऑलराइट, सो व्हाट विल बी द प्रोसीजर ऑफ दिस कॉन्टेस्ट? So every month entries would be invited and among them a maximum of 10 entries will be considered for the awards and the participants will have to post their success stories through a video depicting the efforts and significant contributions that they have contributed towards conserving and managing the water resources. The prize money is rupees 10,000 each and the total duration of the contest is what? It will end on the 31st August 2021, yani ki pura ek saal. right, the duration of this contest is 1 year. It will end 1 year and it will end on 31st August 2021. Okay. So this is about the Water Heroes contest, and the correct answer is option A, to make water conservation a people's movement. This question can be asked in NABARD. This is very important for NABARD and also for RBI grade B. And now let's move on to question number 4 and 5, which is about the Mission Karma Yogi that has been approved by Union Cabinet, right? So recently, guys, the Union Cabinet has approved this program, National Program for Civil Services Capacity Building, Mission Karma Yogi. And this program will enhance the Indian cultural values and sensibilities among the civil servants. Basically, ye program kya hai, main aapko batata hu, that there is a, you know, sabke andar ek tendency hoti hai to work in silos ka matlab hota hai that some people who are working together not sharing information with each other. Okay, ki लोगों को ये लगता है कि हम ज्यादा से ज्यादा आगे निकल जाएं और जो हमारे साथ वाला कोलीग है वो पीछे छूट जाए. सो इस टेंडेंसी को खत्म करने के लिए और इंडियन कल्चरल वैल्यूज यानी कि सबको एक साथ लेके चलने की जो वैल्यू है उसको प्रमोट करने के लिए इस प्रोग्राम को लॉन्च किया गया है. दिस प्रोग्राम विल एनहांस द इंडियन कल्चरल वैल्यूज एलिमिनेटिंग द वर्किंग इन सिलोज वर्किंग इन सिलोज प्रोग्राम या यू नो वर्किंग इन सिलोज वैल्यूज दैट वर अर्लियर देयर इन द there in the all the organizations, right? So this program will enhance the Indian cultural values and sensibilities among the civil servants. So it is an endeavor to reincarnate a government servant into an ideal karma yogi to serve the nation by enabling him to be creative, to be constructive, to be proactive and technically empowered, right? And this is the overview of this Mission Karma Yogi. So it will focus on individual and institutional capacity building, and there is a necessity that we have to build the capacities of our institutes also, then only they'll be able to build the capacity of individual civil servants. Okay, tenure will be 5 years, outlay will be 510 crores, and around 46 lakh central employees will be covered under this Mission Karma Yogi. And there is one capacity building commission which has been proposed to be set up, and this will ensure a uniform approach in managing and regulating the capacity building ecosystem on collaborative and co-sharing basis. And there is one council which is known as Public Human Resources Council that will be headed by Prime Minister, and this council will approve the civil services capacity building plans under the scheme. Jo ye capacity building commission jo bhi plan banayega, that will be approved by the Public Human Resource Council, and this council will consist members like Union Minister, Chief Ministers, eminent public HR practitioners, thinkers, public service functionaries. Okay. And these are the key features of the program. So if you talk about the pillars, so these are some pillars: policy framework, institutional framework, competency framework, digital learning framework, iGOT Karma Yogi, the electronic HRM system, the monitoring and evaluation framework. Inke baare mein aapko detail mein padhne ki koi zarurat nahi hai. You just remember these six pillars of this mission. And these are the principles of this mission, guys. So there is an emphasis on on-site learning to complement the off-site learning. On-site learning ko isme emphasis diya jayega. To support transition from rules based to roles based HRM, role based HRM ko follow karne ka isme rakha gaya hai. To create an ecosystem of shared training infrastructure, to calibrate civil service positions to a framework of roles, activities and competencies approach, to build and strengthen civil servants behavioral, functional and domain competencies. Har sphere ke andar jo civil servant hai uski competency ko build karna hai, uski competency ko strengthen banana hai. To enable government departments to invest in their resources to co-create and share common ecosystem, and content providing partners including startups, universities, public training institution and individual experts, unko bhi include kiya jayega taki zyada se zyada civil servants ki jo competency hai usko build kiya ja sake. Okay, so this was about this Mission Karma Yogi, and now let's move on to question number 4 and 5. So the Union Cabinet has approved launching of a national program for civil services capacity building with what name? So the name of the scheme is Mission Karma Yogi. And question number 5, a public HR council will be set up to approve the civil services capacity building plans. What is not correct about the council? We have to find the incorrect statement. So Supreme Court judge will be the chairperson of the council. No, guys, Prime Minister will be the chairperson, and Prime Minister will select the chairperson. No, this is again incorrect. So both of the statements are the incorrect. Therefore option D will be the correct answer. And now, guys, let's move on to the quiz for the today. Question, there are 5 questions without options. You have to answer each and every question, and at the end of the quiz you have to comment your marks in the comment section. So let me first read out all the questions, and then after reading the fifth question, I'll tell you answers of each and every question. Okay, so under which scheme Ministry of Agriculture will promote the innovation and agripreneurship, thereby promoting startups in the area of agro processing, food technology and value addition. So ye humne bahut detail mein padha tha kis scheme ke antargat Ministry of Agriculture jo hai wo promote karega innovation aur agripreneurship ko. Agripreneurship is the collaboration of agricultural entrepreneurship. Okay, ताकि स्टार्टअप्स को प्रमोट किया जा सके इन द एरिया ऑफ एग्रो प्रोसेसिंग, फूड टेक्नोलॉजी एंड वैल्यू एडिशन. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज, रिसेंटली यूएस पॉलिसी ब्रीफ ऑन द पैंडेमिक्स इंपैक्ट ऑन एजुकेशन वाज रिलीज्ड. अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस पॉलिसी रिपोर्ट, हाउ मेनी चिल्ड्रन मे नॉट रिटर्न टू स्कूल ड्यू टू द पैंडेमिक. अभी रिसेंटली यूएन ने पॉलिसी ब्रीफ लॉन्च किया था ऑन द पैंडेमिक्स इंपैक्ट ऑन एजुकेशन. तो हमें बताना है इस रिपोर्ट के हिसाब से कितने चिल्ड्रन है जो कि पैंडेमिक के बाद स्कूल वापस नहीं जा पाएंगे. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज, इलेक्ट्रॉनिक वैक्सीन इंटेलिजेंस नेटवर्क वॉज लॉन्च्ड अंडर विच मिशन. कौन से मिशन के अंतर्गत इलेक्ट्रॉनिक वैक्सीन इंटेलिजेंस नेटवर्क को लॉन्च किया गया. एंड क्वेश्चन नंबर 4 इज, इन विच टू डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स ऑफ ओडिशा सुनामी रेडी प्रोग्राम वॉज लॉन्च्ड. कौन से दो डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स में ओडिशा के सुनामी रेडी प्रोग्राम को लॉन्च किया गया. एंड क्वेश्चन नंबर 5 इज, विच इंस्टीट्यूट हैज वन द स्मार्ट इंडिया हैकाथॉन प्राइज. कौन से इंस्टीट्यूट को स्मार्ट इंडिया हैकाथॉन प्राइज दिया गया था. सो क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 का आंसर है गाइस, द मिशन इज राष्ट्रीय कृषि विकास योजना. राष्ट्रीय कृषि विकास योजना इज द स्कीम अंडर विच मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर विल प्रमोट द इनोवेशन एंड एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप. एंड राष्ट्रीय कृषि विकास योजना इज नाउ आरकेवीवाई रफ्तार. ओके, इट्स न्यू अवतार इज आरकेवीवाई रफ्तार. एंड रफ्तार स्टैंड्स फॉर, यू शुड रिमेंबर द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ रफ्तार ऑल्सो, रिम्यूनरेटिव अप्रोचेस फॉर एग्रीकल्चर एंड एलाइड सेक्टर फॉर एग्रीकल्चर एंड एलाइड सेक्टर रेजुविनेशन. ओके, लेट मी रिपीट दिस. Remuneration approaches for agriculture and allied sector rejuvenation is the full form of RAFTAR, and this scheme was launched for various objectives like there will be building up of pre and post harvest infrastructure. किसानों के लिए pre और post harvest infrastructure बनाया जाएगा, and under this scheme there will be mitigation of risks of farmer. Okay, so the correct answer is राष्ट्रीय कृषि विकास योजना. And recently, according to this policy, 24 million children. All right, the correct answer is what? 24 million children ऐसे हैं जो कि school, जो कि pandemic के बाद school वापस नहीं जाएंगे. And according to this report, all there are some other facts also, like girls and women are more likely to be affected by this pandemic. There will be loss of learning by 1/3. Loss of learning हो जाएगा by 1/3. And also जो education में हम खर्चा करते हैं, जो education finance है, that will also be decreased because of the pandemic. Okay, let me rub something. Yes, so now let's move on to question number 3. Question number 3 is what? Electronic vaccine intelligence network was launched under which mission? So we have discussed this in detail. So it was launched under the National Health Mission, and there was काफी ज्यादा कोशिश की गई है for the vaccination all over the country. Like in 1985, unified immunization program was launched. It was unified or not? Yes, it was unified immunization program was launched in the year 1985. After this, Mission Indradhanush was launched in the year 2014, and after this, intensified Mission Indradhanush was launched in the year 2017, and also after this, intensified Mission Indradhanush 2.0 was launched in the year 2019. So there were various efforts that was there by the government of India for achieving the 100% immunization in the program. And this is not unified, this is universal immunization program. I beg your pardon, this is universal immunization program. And question number 4 is, in which two districts of Odisha tsunami ready program was launched? So we have discussed in very much detail that India is the first country to implement the tsunami ready program. And in Odisha we have two villages. One is Venkat Raipur in the Ganjam district. Venkat Raipur in the Ganjam district, and other is Nolia Shahi in the Jagat Singhpur district. So these are the two districts, Ganjam and Jagat Singhpur, and the name of the villages is Venkat Raipur and Nolia Shahi. And question number 5 is, which institute has won the Smart India Hackathon prize? Let me again rub this. So Smart India Hackathon prize, guys, it was won by Defense Institute of Advanced Technology, DIAT, which is located in Pune. Okay, once again. Yes, this has been won by DIAT, which is located in Pune, and there are various other initiative that was launched by DIAT, like Ashray, which is a medical bed isolation system. There is one Ananya, which is a disinfectant spray. There is one Pavitra Pati, which is a biodegradable face mask, and there are various other initiatives that has been launched by DIAT. So these are the answers of the quiz. I hope aapke 5 mein se 5 number hai sabhi ke, and that's it for the session today. I hope you like it. For more updates, do subscribe our channel and press the bell icon. Aapko session kaisa laga? Comment karke zarur bataye. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.